Hi everyone, welcome back. I'm Snokus, and this is another episode of our Hearts of Iron 4 series, the Second Spanish Republic. And the Allies recently declared war on Germany, the German Reich declared war on Poland, which then joined the Allies, which meant the Allies got dragged into it. And the interesting thing is that France isn't with them. Due to be having the Red Star here on their flag and all. So hopefully we can swing this into getting them into our faction instead of the Allies. And maybe we can do something interesting with that. We're still trying to capitalize on this issue here. Because even though it's hard to break through, when we are through, it's going to be easier to defend it. Which would mean that their offensive down here would have a bit of an issue for a while. Before we do that, because I didn't... Actually, you know what, let's keep going, because we have one more bonus being researched in the focus tree right now, but we can get that for the guerrilla warfare one. So for now, let's get the human wave offensive, which gives us greater combat width and greater recruitable population, so that's one's nice. Hopefully we're going to be up to 150 political power soon as well, so that we can get some more recruitable population that way. Let's try to do this. As soon as this guy's gone, we're going to go. Come on, you can do it. Yeah, here we go. Ah, fuck. That's not at all what I had in mind. Oh, we can do it. We can do it. Yes. Well, alright. That played out as usual. Somewhat to my part and somewhat due to the AI. But, you know, you can't win every time. We are going to be a bit starved until we get more manpower. But that's just how it is. Come on now, France. I know you want to join us. We have the best parties. We have the socialist parties. Yeah, but anyway, this is going alright for now. We are protecting our sphere of influence here. I imagine Britain have a bit of a hard time in the Mediterranean to win the naval fight. But when we join, we will be able to help them out somewhat. We don't have a huge navy, but we have enough of a navy. Mostly subs and one battleship, but you know, we should be able to at least blockade Italy somewhat. Seems like Belgium and Netherlands are losing. They haven't lost yet. Belgium has lost one county here, or whatever you want to call it, province, I guess. Netherlands are holding out for now. So yeah, it's gonna be interesting to see how that turns out. Finland is not in a war right now, but they are going to be soon when Soviet Union decides to attack. Soviet Union is not in a war with anyone, but they might be in a war with Germany soon. Yeah, there we go. That's quite stupid, considering Germany doesn't hold France or even the... Benelux nations yet. Well, come the fuck on, France. Why did you do that? Well, alright. Let's join the Comintern then, I guess. Here we go. Let's take the usual path we invade Italy here. And actually, let's take a look at Division de Infanteria. Yep. Non-aggression pact sounds nice. Division de Infanteria, we don't have any recon company. Let's get that. We don't have that great of a combat width. Let's get some cavalry. Sure, that sounds fine. Could be interesting to see if any of the... let's get some oil from the US instead. Or not. Yeah, that they have a much larger production base anyway, so come on now. How much do we need? Holy hell, look at the flux here. Would be interesting to see if we're lacking one steel. That's fine, we don't need... Well, hey, we can actually get one from France. Would be interesting to see if any of the United Kingdom dominions would change to fascist or something. They don't seem to be, but it could be interesting to see. That's what the latest DLC was for anyway. It's 9:40 now, so let's get some better research. Leningrad is already fallen, which is St. Petersburg in modern terms. What are you doing? You are just chilling out down here. Oh, right, we got you back from China. Yeah, because we're at war, so they automatically goes back. That's fine. We got some better artillery now. As you can see, things are speeding up quite a bit, which is nice. It's fun. Get some better conscription. Another 500,000 manpower. That's great. Let's put you in this army, and let's put you as a general here, a much better general. And then when the planning is done and everyone's here, we're gonna charge on through. Alright, so we should reconsider this army here. Everyone that is not a mountaineer will create their own army. And go on to reinforce this border here. And let's create a bit of a attack plan here, just so we start building up that planning bonus. You guys are gonna create a fallback line right here. Good. We got a bunch of non-aggression packs here, so let's accept them all. Did I give you a general? Can't remember, I did. Good. Got 18 units in this tile alone. Do not know what that's for. Well, whatever. Yeah, so Union probably gonna attack Finland soon. As of right now, Germany seem to be making some progress into Soviet Union, which isn't great for us, but we can handle it for now. And eventually, hopefully in the future as well, but we do not... change the tide? Yeah. We do have enough units to reinforce these borders, which is nice. It's exactly what we wanted. We do want some backup units there, just in case. And we have a whole army here, for Christ's sake, if we would need it. So hopefully this coup gets started soon so we can back it up and invade Portugal. Anyway, that's not what I wanted to do. Are you ready to go? You are? Well, let's go. Italy decides to attack Yugoslavia when they are attacked on pretty much every front. I'm not sure how smart that is, but sure. How is our equipment looking? It's looking fine. Good. And China does not seem to be winning, although they are going to have backup from the Soviet Union now. And you are in a faction with regular China, so we won't be able to invite you. That's just how it is. Just like Italy might attack Yugoslavia and create even more enemies, the Union might attack Finland and create even more enemies, which would be bad for us because we do need them to focus all of their defense against the Germans right now. But the AI isn't great. Okay, so Germany did the same thing and pretty much dragged Norway into the fight as well. And they're gonna do the same thing against Denmark here soon, I imagine. Well, you know, that's just how the cookie crumbles. Holy shit. I'm gonna stop the attack for now. We are gonna try again when we get the opportunity to. Let's move you around a bit so that you can reinforce some other tiles. Yeah, there we go. Let's see how well Denmark can defend. It should be able to defend somewhat, seeing how Germany has is occupied in some other areas right now. You know what, actually, before we do that, okay, Marines aren't researched yet, so never mind. Well, we are safeguarding France, so I guess that's the important part. Although we did lose this fort, I think. Unless Germany held that before. No, Germany held that before, so it's actually us that has taken... it's our side that has managed to take Luxembourg here. Okay, so... Yugoslavia wanna send some troops to help us out, sure. I got nothing against that. How far before this is done? 19th of July, which is another 2 months or so. July. Yeah. All right, this is going all right. We should use our fleet, right? You should not just chill for now. Let's. Which can search and destroy in the Western Mediterranean. So that we can secure our landing when we decide to land troops on Sardinia. Which we are gonna do as soon as we get the opportunity to. Which means as soon as we get our... what are they called? Marines. In the meantime, let's check out this armor division. We aren't producing any motorized, which we should maybe do that. So let's scale back. Infantry equipment a bit and get some more motorized. And let's get you the support you need. And then let's start producing you. We do want a combat width of about 20. Yep, so let's add some tanks and some motorized. We can't actually afford that, so let's do that later. And then let's start production of a couple. Let's start with maybe 3. We are gonna have a bit of a deficit on motorized to begin with, but we are hopefully gonna retake that quickly. Recover that quickly. Anyway, Marines, another 9 days, that's fine. Japan is still making gains, I believe, somewhat. Not against the communists, but somewhat against regular China. That's not great, but I imagine China would do better if they didn't have a front against France here. I don't imagine socialist France is against... Alright, they are. They aren't socialist, the largest part of China. But anyway, everyone wants to move troops through our territory. I don't know why. We don't have that much territory. I suppose some of that will be this crossing here, but still. Alright, so marines are done. Let's start getting some. Come on now. I think you can only invade with 6 to begin with. So let's start with a division, an army of 6, a force of 6, I guess. That should be fine for now. Yep. This, there's no way they're gonna break through the Maginot line. Menkoku capitulated. That's great. But they do have some territory left. What I am a bit worried about is well, the historical. France does have forts here though. So they might be able to defend somewhat, but I am worried that Germany is gonna break through here and we won't be able to react. Well, let's get going with the mechanization effort then. Netherlands capitulated, SOG submitted to Italy, which I believe is now Albania maybe? I don't actually know. Yeah, Albania. King SOG, right. Well, alright then. I'm thinking about removing our units from the Maginot Line, seeing how I probably aren't needed there, and instead move them to the Belgian line. And the more I think of it, I'm probably gonna do just that. Something like that, and then somewhat of a line here, just a tile or so we get the planning bonus still. Just to secure this line here, so they don't break through. That's quite important.
Ordenes?
Where are... Oh, we have 18 units in this tile alone. Fantastic. All of these tiles are mountains, so no use trying to break through, I suppose. I might have fucked up when I drew that front line there. But I do that sometimes. That's on me, I guess. Let's create another offensive line here. Something like that. Mirroring the French one. How's the war going overall? Well, Germany seems to be winning. For some reason. Well, I guess due to the Soviet Union losing ground. We do not want them to lose Moscow. That would be the end of us, pretty much. Losing Leningrad isn't great, but they can survive it, hopefully at least. Well, now that these guys are set up correctly, maybe we should try again. Just to see... yeah, okay, let's not. Let's let them carry through that single attack here, and then have them stand off for a while. We do want this one to fire, and it's gonna take another month or so, about 3 weeks. And then the Azores workers are gonna rise up against the oppressive Portuguese kingdom, I believe they are. And then we can ask them to join. No, we can't, because it isn't our faction. Oh, well, alright. That's stupid. Anyway, maybe by some other means we can attack into Portugal anyway. Otherwise, we'll just free up our units and use them to force our armies across Germany instead. Also, soon we're going to have our Marines, and let's get them to the top so they get priority here. And then we can take Sardinia, which do have some factories, and then we can march on through Rome and so on. Is Rome the most important one? No, even Tuscany is better, it seems. Romagna, Lombardy is really good. Piedmont is also really good. Savoy is also quite good. Holy shit, okay, the north is evidently much better than the south. I suppose that has to do with historical development, stuff like that. But anyway, hopefully you liked this episode, and please leave a like if you want to see more of this series. And well, yeah, that's pretty much it for me for today. Just remember, be a nice person, and hopefully see you next time. Bye.